In this presentation, we will look at breach of trust. Trustees are jointly and severally liable for any breach of the trust or fiduciary duty which causes a loss to the beneficiaries of the trust. The liability of the trustee is personal through the remedy, though the remedy can be either personal or proprietary and at common law or in equity. If one trustee acts unilaterally and this action constitutes a breach of trust, the individual trustee concerned will be solely liable. However, each trustee has a duty to watch over and, if necessary, correct the conduct of his fellow trustees. This is of particular importance where professional trustees are appointed. In some cases, which we will discuss later, a remedy can also be sought against third parties for breach of trust. Common actions which constitute a breach of trust are distribution of trust properties to a beneficiary who is not entitled to those assets under the terms of the trust instrument, investing the trust fund in a way not permitted by the trustee's express or statutory powers of investment, breaching the fiduciary duty such as not to personally profit from the trust, operating a business that competes with the business interests of the trust, investing without exercising reasonable care and skills when managing the trust. Generally, the liability of breach of trust is strict, even if the trustee believed he was acting in accordance with the terms of the trust. The mental state of the trustees is irrelevant. No dishonesty, negligence, or criminal element of mens rea is required. However, if no loss arises directly from the breach of trust, the trustees concerned will not be held liable. The claimant must, therefore, prove both breach and loss flowing from the breach. It should also be noted that beneficiaries have a common law duty to mitigate their loss. Failure to do so may reduce the trustee's liability.